afternoon, people. I am Sejal Kamble, and I'm the first speaker to go against the topic. What is education? Education is neither a privilege nor is it a favor. It is but a basic human right that the Constitution of India has bestowed upon us. It is a basic human right that all of us are entitled to. India is a land of 1.3 billion people, out of which 64.4% of the population is youth, that is in the category of 18 to 30 years of age. We will have the greatest youth force in the world, approximately 140 million from up till 2030. India has the third largest universities, and in terms of higher education, we are lagging only behind USA and China. India has almost 800 universities, 33,000 colleges, and greater than 20 million students. And yet, only 1 out of 7 children in India get to go to colleges, where China spends approximately 4.5 to 6% of its GDP on education. We, in 2018, have spent only 3.7% of our GDP on education and even more less on higher education. Our gross enrollment ratio stands at one of the lowest, with just 25.6, which is much, much lower than the world average. The literacy rate in India, though increasing, is still just 74% against the world average of 84%. I'll talk about the four broad challenges that the Indian higher education system faces. There's a supply and demand gap. There's low rate of enrollment, just 18% as against 26% of the world average. We have low quality of teachers and low quality of learning. There are constraints on research capacity and innovation. Indian government spends less than 1% of their GDP on research. We do not have a research-centric approach towards higher education. There's uneven growth and access to opportunity. You know, guys, by 2020, India needs 400 million university places, which is an increase of 14 million from the current stage that we stand at right now. And we'll need 500 million skilled workers by 2030 if we have to rope in the entire youth population and take advantage of the demographic dividend that we are in right now. The major problems that face the higher education in Indian universities is the increasing gap between education and employability. According to the industry standards, just 30% of the graduate youth in India are employable. Such a dismal state of affairs, right? There are many seats that are left vacant every year. Even if we can see a lot of mushrooming colleges in the country, we can see many private institutions coming up, yet only 30% of the graduates are employable. We have the urban-rural divide. We have a lot of disparities. We have interstate disparities where one state of Kerala has the highest literacy rate, while on the other side, Bihar and UP have one of the lowest literacy rates in the country. We have disparities across communities, which is why we are forced to give reservations to certain communities based on religion, which is not a good thing to do. We have disparities across genders. Males are more prominent and females less prominent. We have only 30% of the graduates which are employable, which I've already told. We have the international student ratio at the lowest. We have the lowest number of international students coming and studying in our universities. We have such low tie-ups with foreign universities that we cannot allow these students to come and study in our universities. We have the big plague problem of reservation. Reservation is something that the higher education in India needs to be done with. We have multiple regulators in the higher education industry. We have AICTE, we have UGC, we have CIMA, and all the other regulators making it even a more complex state of affairs. Even though now we have the Higher Education Commission of India Bill of 2018, it has yet not been passed. It is still stranded in the Sabha. You know why? Because this bill tends to replace the UGC with some other autonomous body, and the promise of the Modi government that there will be education for all, this step of the Higher Education Commission of India Bill is a step towards in that direction. Yes, And so I again repeat that we have a long way to go when it comes to increasing the state of affairs in the higher education of India. We have done a lot, but then we have a long way to go. We have such a huge demographic dividend to take care of, and at the stage at which we are allocating the funds or at which we are progressing, I feel we have a long way to go when it comes to the state of increasing the or improving the state of higher education in India. Thank you.